As a reminder, a network enables a collection of interconnected machines to exchange data. A network consists of three types of physical components. First, end devices, which are the machines at the end of the chain, such as computers, printers, or servers. Then, network equipment, which are intermediary devices that interconnect the end devices on the network. This includes devices like switches and routers. Finally, cables transmitting electrical signals, optical fiber conveying light waves, radio waves, and so on, which transports data across the network. Additionally, networks can be classified based on their geographical coverage: PAN, LAN, MAN, and WAN. PAN, or personal area network, is a personal network covering a small area, allowing devices in the same vicinity to communicate. PANs often involve devices like smartphones, laptops, headphones, and mice. It encompasses USB connections. There's also the wireless PAN, which relies on technologies like Bluetooth or NFC for near-field communication. Wireless PANs find extensive use in the context of the Internet of Things, connecting devices such as smartwatches and connected bulbs. LAN, or local area network, covers a limited geographical area, like a building, house, hospital, or school. LAN involves terminal devices exchanging data within a confined zone. A classic example of a LAN is an office's local network, where multiple work computers share file servers and network printers. The most popular type of LAN is Ethernet LAN. Ethernet LAN is distinguished by its wired connection method, using twisted pair cables for reliable and high-speed data transmission within a confined geographical area. There's also a wireless variant, the wireless LAN, mainly based on radio wave transmission and commonly known as Wi-Fi. Moving on to MAN, or Metropolitan Area Network, it connects several nearby LANs as if they were part of a single local network. Essentially, a MAN covers an entire city with local network technology. MANs consist of switches or routers linked through high-speed connections, often fiber optic. Finally, WAN, or Wide Area Network, covers long distances, such as across a country or continent. A WAN interconnects multiple LANs or MANs over extensive geographical areas. The most significant WAN is the public internet. International organizations can also establish private WANs, as seen in banking networks or stockbroker systems. WANs rely on infrastructure like fiber optics, international undersea cables, or satellite transmissions. We've reached the end of this video. I hope it was informative and enjoyable. If you want to keep up with the latest in tech and computer science, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. Your support is incredibly important, and I can't wait to delve into more tech topics with you in our future videos. Goodbye.